Welcome to Babushka. I'm Bab. This is Ocean.
That's Hayden.
We thought we'd start off by just introducing ourselves a little bit. So this is Hayden. Hayden has a really annoying habit of starting anecdotes but never finishing them.
Funny you should say that. That really reminds me of this time when I was 7.
Hi, my name's Mark Bittlestone. I'm from Kingston and I'm reading Management Studies.
Mark is addicted to the university challenge.
Jeremy Paxson's got a restraining order on me.
And Declan here left home age 16.
And then returned home later that day when school was finished.
Anyway, we've got 60 minutes of sketches coming up for you.
We've got lots of jokes. Oh, yeah, lots of jokes.
Yeah, we've got like 10 jokes.
Yeah, that was one of them. get your good material out of the way first.
we thought we'd start off by explaining the concept. So it's called Babushka because, like a Russian doll, each sketch is going to be nestled inside the other.
Yeah. And in addition to that, like inside a Babushka doll, there's nothing in there. There's going to be nothing but us. No tech, no dress, no props.
We do say that though. We actually do have one prop, which if you spot, there will be points.
We all know what points mean. Nothing.
But the main reason we decided to call the show Babushka is because Declan does a perfect impression of a Babushka doll. Declan, can you do your impression, please?
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. And also to honour the Russian doll theme, for the grand finale, I am literally going to climb out of Mark.
No, we cut that. I'm going to climb out of Mark.
No. I'm going to climb out of Declan into you.
Right, okay. Let's move on. So let's explain the concept a little bit. In every sketch, there will be a word or a little phrase that will reference what the next sketch is going to be about. For example...
Hi, John. Can I get the number of a doctor, please?
What's that? An alien space landing?
So obviously, the next sketch would be about... a guy called John. It's very simple.
And irrelevant.
Anyway, are we ready for the first real sketch? Yeah!
Enjoy the show! Hello everybody, welcome to the annual general meeting of the RSPB.
RSPB!
Now, looking around the room, you might notice we've got a new member today, a new little hatchling, if you will. Welcome to Robin, a man whose dedication to avian matters even extends to his name. Okay, let's stop messing around, shall we? Lionel, would you like to tell us, sir, what you've been up to in the bird world recently?
Thank you. Yes, I've been going around removing the protective casing from bird feeders so that squirrels and rats get the nuts. Birds near Lionel 1. Ooh!
What? Please carry on.
Thank you. I've also been going around collecting osprey eggs to take home for my collection of smashed osprey eggs. Oh!
They're an endangered
species. Just yesterday, I saw a blue tit and squashed it in the pole.
What? I thought this was the Royal Society for the Protection of Birds.
It's happened again. No. This is the Royal Society for the Prevention of Birds.
What have you got against birds?
A bird once shat on my head.
I decided to wage war on an entire animal group because one of them once shat on your head.
Yes.
Well, you're a pair of psychopaths, I'm out of it.
Oh no, please, we're lacking in numbers, we need you to stay. But don't worry, we're moving on to the next meeting, okay?
What's the next meeting?
The RSPCA.
RSPCA! The RSPCA.
Yes, the Royal Society for the Promotion of Cruelty to Animals.
So on our left, we've got Queen's College, named after Sir Wallace of Nortwood.
Cool.
On your right, you've got King's College, the College of John Maynard Keynes, Alan Turing, and Gareth Gates. Yeah. On your left, sorry, my left.
We're facing the same way, we're not.
You'll see Homerton College, right next to the biggest bridge on the river, the Bridge of Sighs.
Cool. What bridge is that? It's
Brooklyn Bridge. Awesome. On your right, behind those buildings, you'll see the square turrets of Keble College.
Now, Keble College is in Oxford.
No, it's not. Oh, there's my favourite river dwellers, the ducks. There's Quentin, there's Quacky, there's that guy who always pretends to be a duck.
What?
On your left, you'll see an alleyway leading down to the Eagle Pub. It's the alleyway where I lost my virginity. On your right, you'll see Claire Backs, my favourite place in Cambridge. I'd like to just come here in the summer to work in peace and live. It's also where me and Jake killed a man. With a spade. Okay. Cut off his neck.
Wow.
Threw him in the river.
Congratulations, you've passed your punting exam.
God, my mum is like so annoying.
Oh, tell me about it. Parents are the worst. My dad is so middle-aged.
Son, it's time for the jousting tourney. Get on your chainmail, we're going to the tavern.
Like I said, so middle-aged. All right, lads. It's been a tricky first half, but we're not helping ourselves out, yeah? We've got to be better on the ball.
It's difficult, boss. They're first to everything.
Well, we got to want it more.
Thing is, they keep spinning round and round and round and round, so they get more powerful kicks than us, but the ref isn't picking up on it.
Well, their table, their rules.
Thing is, the ball keeps getting stuck in the middle.
Yeah, they're physically in midfield, that's how they play.
No, the ball is literally getting stuck in the exact centre of the pitch so no one can reach it.
We've trained for that, we can play the waiting game.
Boss, I really think we need to change formation.
No. We play two at the back, five in the middle, and three up top, like always.
2-5-3, we're too attack focused. We're vulnerable on the counter, boss.
Our formation is not the issue. What we need to stop doing, and I'm looking at you here, Martin, yeah, he's going for the ball, all right, yeah, missing it, yeah, panicking, and then backing it into your own head. Because Gary here isn't ready for that. Now, what happened for their 12th goal?
Well, we didn't get any instructions from you, Gaffer, so we all just sort of lay there, horizontal, 1 metre above the ground.
That one was my fault, accept it, but, Martin, I hate to keep picking on you, but I've had a look at your distance cover and your movement, it's very lateral, yeah? We're too flat, lads. What's happened out there?
I just think our game plan is too one-dimensional.
Exactly. We're over-reliant on the ability of our goalkeeper, Gary, to score screamers from his own line.
Yeah, a pass would be nice, Gary.
Sorry, Martin. Who's the top scorer in this team? Is it me, the goalie, or you, the right-back? All right, shite back.
All right, Gary, grow up, mate. You're not Superman. Anyway, there's plenty of metrics to measure a first half apart from goals. Zero offsides, yet another clean duvet. Anyway, big second half coming up. Any last words from the captain?
Yeah, if you really want us to win this game, then what would help is if you were to untie our legs and remove us from this skewer. It's really painful. I've lost a lot of blood. And I'm pretty sure Darren in left back has died.
Anyway, big second half, lads. Off we pop.
Right, mate, got your pint.
Oh, cheers, thank you.
Were you just talking to the table football players?
Oh, yeah, just giving them a half-match team talk. You know how it is.
Right, you know, they're not real.
Yeah, of course they're not. Just a bit of a joke, you know.
Right, okay, I'm just going to go to the loo, right?
Superman, thank you so much for saving me from the clutches of that generic supervillain. How will I ever be able to repay you?
Don't worry about it, romantic plot device. I've got to go. There are people out there that need to be saved.
Oh, Superman, I'll never forget you.
Goodbye, Lois.
All right, cut!
Okay, so, Lois, take five. Need to talk to Superman.
Okay, thanks, guys!
So, Oh, you thought it was alright? Oh, well, I guess it's fine then. I guess fine if you thought it was alright, considering you're in charge of this film.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, exactly. So let's have a look at the screen. Yeah? What did it say here?
As Superman
flies off into distance.
Yeah.
Right. What else is this? Oh, look, it's your CV. It says here, happy to do own stunts.
Yeah, I do my own stunts.
What was that? Hmm? You come here to play the part of Superman. You said you can do your own stunts. You can't even fly. Did you really think it wouldn't come up?
I thought that would be like CGI.
Oh, Oh, you've got to CGI. CGI. Computer generated imagery.
Exactly.
Right. Does this look like a computer to you?
No, Russ.
Yeah, exactly. Do I look like a computer?
No.
Do you look like a computer?
I don't know.
When you look in the mirror every morning, do you see a man or do you see a computer?
Me.
Yeah, exactly. It's called Superman because that exists. Supercomputer, that doesn't.
Okay. So you're saying that if I was to audition for the role of Batman, I would have to become a bat?
No, I would kill your parents.
What? That's ridiculous.
Have you not heard of method acting? Maybe I should have cast someone who actually commits to their roles, like Daniel Day-Lewis.
Could Daniel Day-Lewis fly?
He would make it work.
I'm pretty sure Daniel Day-Lewis can't fly.
And I was pretty sure I hadn't cast an incompetent prick, but here we are proving that wrong. You will never work in Hollywood again. You are out, you are fired. Do you have any talents whatsoever?
Well, I can fire web out of my hands on demand.
Well, why didn't you say so? I've got the perfect job for you.
Really?
My next film, Charlotte's Web.
What's up, man?
Too much.
I've just realised that Batman has broken my window.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Why's he done that?
Don't know. It's fucking ridiculous, man. I hate him.
It's just outrageous. Just wandering around the town, smashing cars, breaking into houses. What the fuck is wrong with
you? You know what? I think it's time we tackle the problem of vigilantism ourselves. Right, we are, sir. Right outside your brand new house in the country. Shall we have a look inside?
Yeah.
So, here we have the master bedroom, which I think doubles up nicely as a great reception room.
Yeah, lovely.
Let's have a look next door. Here we have the guest bedroom.
Really nice. Could work so well for our little boy or girl.
So, what do you think?
I really like it so far.
So far?
Well, where's the rest of it?
Well, you asked for two-bedroom house in the country.
Yeah, we wanted a bathroom as well.
You should have asked for a two-bedroom, one-bathroom house.
What about the kitchen?
Oh, I see what you've done. You wanted a two-bedroom, one-bathroom, one-kitchen house.
Well, that's incredibly misleading. Is this a scam?
Sorry, sir. The papers are signed. My hands are tied. The property is now yours.
My wife will be expecting a bathroom.
Well, she shouldn't be.
She'll be furious. I'll be sleeping on the sofa for weeks.
No, you won't. There's no sofa.
Can't we bring our own?
Yes, but
where are you going to put it?
You're focusing on the negatives. Focus on the positives. Very desirable area. Lots of celebrities in the locale. Gareth Gates is actually buried nearby.
Gareth Gates is still alive.
Is he? Must be a different Gareth Gates. The property's also listed.
Oh, really?
On Zoopla. Now, the best bit till last. Let's go back into the master bedroom. Now, this is the walk-in wardrobe.
Wow, Sandra loves those.
Now, have you seen Narnia?
Yeah.
I haven't. So here we have the walk-in wardrobe, which I think doubles up nicely as the guest bedroom.
That is the guest bedroom!
Flexible, isn't it? Now, this is probably a good time for me to mention what we at the office like to call the seasonal flooding issue.
What issue?
The seasonal flooding. Oh.
Calamity. My wife's heavily pregnant, my marriage is falling apart, I'm struggling at work, and we don't have a fucking bathroom!
Well, I'll let you settle in, Mr. Johnson.
Johnson?
Gosh, you're Mr. Jones! Oh, I'm so sorry. This is not your place.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, this place is way out of your budget.
Disc jockey.
All right, mate, got some really good news.
Oh, did the test results come back negative?
No. But I won £21 million!
What? £21 million?
Yeah, an elderly relative died.
So sorry, who was it?
My Nigerian uncle, Chukwuma Kaduna Nazawegu.
You have a Nigerian uncle, you're from Grimsby.
I know.
Right, so he didn't have any other friends or family? He didn't have any other Nigerian friend.
No. Just me.
Well, drinks on you tonight then. When did the money arrive?
Right. You know the phrase, you've got to spend money to make
money? Yes.
I've spent some money.
Oh, not again.
Just a couple of grand to cover postage and packaging before Jaquima's lawyers can send the rest of the 21 million over.
I'm pretty sure you've been scammed. How do you know the money's going to arrive?
I'll tell you exactly how I know, because they misspelt almost every word in the email. Why would they go to the bother of sending out an email just to misspell almost every single thing?
Double bluffing you.
Why would my own family double bluff me?
Have you even met this uncle?
Have I met Chukwuma?
Yes, have you?
Yes.
When?
At my wedding.
You're not married.
My cousin's wedding. I lent him a feather hat. I haven't met Chukwuma.
Nope.
Fuck.
Yeah, exactly. I cannot believe you keep falling for these things. Remember last week? I'm the lucky millionth visitor to the website.
Oh, I thought I was.
You were on Google.
I was feeling lucky.
Jesus Christ. Of all the things to fall for, the Nigerian uncle. Come on.
Shit. Mr. Selden, thank God we found you. We got your 21 million. And one last thing. Uncle Chukwuma said, thanks for the hat.
I told you! I knew it was true! I knew. And it just gets better from here. When these bills kick in, I'm gonna have a massive dip.
Knock knock, son, are you playing your video games?
But you're not wanking!
I'm just reading a book, guys.
Oh,
you can come
cool,
in.
Great. Reading. Yeah, okay. So, son, your mother and I, we just thought it would be a good time, because you're old enough now, to have the chat.
The chat?
Yeah, you know, the birds and the bees, the old one. I'm going to spell it out for you, okay? S-E...
Hardcore penetrative intercourse.
Explain it to you with a little analogy, okay? Okay. Have you seen the first Harry Potter film?
Yeah.
Okay, so you know the bit where they go into platform 9 3/4? Yeah, that bit. It's like that.
Right, okay.
But sometimes people don't want to do the set, do the thing, right? For example, when you're tired or, you know, when you've got a cold.
Or an STD.
So have you seen the second Harry Potter?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know when they try and get into platform 9 3/4 and can't?
Access denied.
Yeah. It's like that. Okay, I'm not explaining this correctly. Have you watched
porn, Jonathan?
you got straight, lesbian,
massive dick.
Please. Essentially, it's very important to talk to you about this because of safe sex, yeah?
Yeah, it's very important to have a safety word.
No, Julian.
You know, banana, goulash, or stop whipping me, Pete, stop!
Who is Pete?
Nobody, Paul!
The best way of practicing safe sex is to always wear a condom, okay?
Yes, we'll get you some for Christmas, dear.
Yes. Now, essentially, sex is a beautiful, beautiful thing between two consenting adults.
Or more than two.
It's where you try and invoke pleasure in your partner.
Mm-hmm. And fail.
Right. I'm finished. The lesson we really want to instill in you right now is that it's a very intense emotional experience. We just don't want you to get hurt. Okay.
Unless you like that, keep whipping me, Paul! Keep whipping me!
Paul.
I don't know, Pete! No one!
Safe.
Guys, please stop! I've had sex before. I'm married with two kids.
Hi, Mum, how you doing?
Oh, hey, your son!
What are you up to?
Oh, you know, just selling shells. You know how it is.
Why, Mum, why do you have to sell seashells in a place where there is already such an obvious natural abundance?
It was my thing. Where's Sue? Oh, she's by the shore.
It's just ridiculous, okay? Why do you have to sell them here?
You know, logistical reasons.
No one's ever going to buy one from
Excuse
you.
Excuse me, I had a lot of interest yesterday.
Yeah, and what happened?
They picked one up from over there.
Exactly. But there's seashells everywhere. It's basic supply and demand. This is why we're so poor.
I think it has a lot more to do with the general financial recession. And your father leaving us.
It has nothing to do with the microeconomy.
Don't call your father that.
Why don't you just sell shells somewhere else?
What, like in a bus stop?
No. Actually, why don't you just ditch the whole seashells thing altogether?
But everyone loves seashells. You put them to your ear, you can hear the sea.
Because we're by the sea.
If I don't sell seashells, who would provide it to the people who put it in their bathrooms?
John Lewis. Just sell something else.
Okay, I could sell ice to the Eskimos.
No.
Sand to the Arabs.
No, you're just playing on lazy racial stereotypes.
I could sell rare Amazonian herbal remedies.
Yeah?
In the Amazon.
No!
I could sell Diet Coke to the Jews.
What? What's that? Don't do that! What's wrong with you?
You're stopping outside the box.
Get back in your box! Mum, the world of retail is not for you.
Fine. It was only a hobby anyway. My boyfriend brings in the real money.
Hello, I'm your mother's boyfriend.
What's he wearing?
A pack of pickled peppers.
You couldn't fucking write it. I suppose your name's Peter Piper, is it?
No, my name's Alan. I'm an accountant.
So, Declan and Mark.
Yeah.
Hello.
How's it going?
Yeah.
Now, I've got some ideas for the show. Mm-hmm. Thought I'd just sort of test them out. How about we try and do an improvised sketch? Now, I've got quite a lot of improv experience.
Oh, really?
So,
The Infernauts.
Yeah. I just did the improv. Yeah. So yes. I thought I could maybe teach you guys the basics of improv, and we can come up with a really fun sketch.
Yeah, that could work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So Declan, let's come up with a scene. So where are we?
Pembroke New Cellars.
No, we need to come up with like a new place to do the scene.
Okay. Pembroke Old Cellars.
Okay. Yeah. Fine. Let's do a scene in Pembroke Old Cellars.
Cool.
No. Sort of illusion.
Oh. Theatre.
Yeah. Okay.
Pretending. Okay.
Me and you, Pembroke Old Cellars.
Yeah. Sure. So, right.
Hey, man. How are you?
What's my line, son?
You just roll with it. You say what you want.
Oh, I say what?
Just
anything
make it up.
Want, so you
make it
great.
Up.
Okay.
Yeah, great. Cool. Let's try again. Me
yeah. Sure.
Okay. Oh my God! Is that the time?
No, that's your wrist.
No, you've got to sort of like bounce off what I say.
Right.
Like you've got to accept the offer. Accept the offer. Okay.
Okay.
So me and Mark, let's
we'll
try one. Okay. Where are we? Let's be in a hairdresser's.
Hairdresser.
Okay.
Sure. Oh, tractor beam. That's really. Oh, yep.
Yep. Tractor beam.
Yep.
Cool. So me and you, hairdressers.
Yeah, wait. Just. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
You there?
Yeah.
Great. Cool. Hi, sir. Can I get a short? Can I get you a short back and side?
I have alopecia.
Again, no. We need to sort of like accept the opposite. Like, if I suggest that you have hair,
I don't have alopecia.
Me and you, let's try another one.
Cool.
Me and you, in a disco.
In 2016.
Yeah, okay. In a disco. Hey man, can I have this dance?
Oh my God, the ground is made of lava! Accept the offer, Hayden. Come on, I suggest it. Play by your own rules.
Fine. Good. Oh, look, I found an island in the lava. Can I have this dance?
Only if you put your dick away. Accept the offer, Hayden.
Fine, bring your dick away.
I could enter the
scene. Yeah, you come in now. That'll look cool.
Just come in if you're going to come in. Don't announce it. Just come in.
I'm straight in. Cool. Hi, guys.
Hi, Sharon. How's the baby?
I'm not pregnant. I'm a tree.
Accept the offer, guys. You two try and do a scene.
Yeah,
we'll
do one.
You're in a coffee shop.
Been there before.
I also.
Yeah, you're in a coffee shop.
Yeah. Hi there. Can I get a decaf hot chocolate, please? How? I'm just joking. I'll
take a caffeine out.
I'll do that. Yeah,
easy. Cheers. Shaken, not stirred.
Oh, yeah.
No, it's not on my team. Sorry. Poor joke. I should just leave the customer.
Marshmallows on top.
Yeah.
Guys, sorry. Can I quickly get a cappuccino? Sorry, I'm in a rush. Sorry to cut in like this.
Can you be quiet, please? This is a library.
Okay, we're gonna then just try one more where we're just fellows at Cambridge.
No, wait, I've got an idea. I've got an idea. How about we move on from this sketch and stop improvising?
No, not yet.
Accept the offer!
Quid quid nobis appositum est, et quid quid appenator benedictum. Amen.
Amen.
Fine if it took you 6 years to complete your PhD.
All right.
Fine if it took you 8 months to realize you were allowed to walk on the grass.
Right, okay, on to the matter at hand. For starters, I'm having a crap pate, my good man. Thank you. Now, first item on the agenda, the distribution of college finances.
Fantastic. How are we doing it this year?
The tried and tested fair method, spin the bottle. Now, in the running we have Newton College Mathematical Society, in need of new compasses. The Newton College Orienteering Society, also in need of new compasses. The Boat Club and the Port to Port Society.
Remind me, what's the Port to Port again?
Where we sail around on ships and drink port.
The Academy!
Port to port, travelling the world, getting all the girls, but mainly drinking port! Oi!
Fuck me up, right? Jesus Christ!
You split the atom!
Right. Okay, let's spin the bottle, alright? Oh, it's landed on the Orienteering Society.
They can get lost! Spin it again!
Oh, look at that, it's landed on the port to port!
Port to port! Traveling the world! Getting all the girls! We're mainly drinking more!
Okay. Right. Next item on the agenda, disciplinary measures. Now, the porters have been receiving a lot of noise. The porters have been receiving a lot of noise complaints from room D7 tennis court. Does anybody know who lives there? All right, okay. Seriously though, fellows, eh? Alright, okay.
Fellows?
Yes. The college does seem to have a serious drug problem.
Yes! I can't find drugs anywhere! I roamed around the college the other day like a sniff a dog on heat. I couldn't find anything. I chanced upon this one chap's room. He had all the telltale signs. Unnecessarily psychedelic patterns on his bedspreads. Lava lamps, green tea, that sort of thing. Clearly a student who studied social anthropology. I thought to myself, Archibald, you've wrapped the weasel on the snout. He's bound to have a stash. Turns out he was just a massive cunt.
Terrible. But we'll move on to the next item, a list of fellows receiving pay rises next year. So up first we have Tarquinius Bamsbury Smythe, 3rd Viscount of Smanglechester, 4th Earl of Putney, 7th in line to the throne of Denmark, and 6th in the 100 metre dash at the 1930 Olympics.
Well done, Smythe!
Thank you very much. Oh, just a second, chap, sir. The waiter's whispering in my ear. Oh, good lord. Chap, sir. Some bad news. It's about the port.
Port to port!
No. It's serious. We've run out of port.
Bully, bugger, and balderdash.
I'm only joking. No, we haven't run out of port. The dean is dead.
Yeah, where's your anti-bullying wristband?
I don't have one.
Oh, yeah.
Declan!
Yeah?
He doesn't have an anti-bullying wristband.
Oh. Oh. Oh, dear.
Should we just go and get him one?
Yeah, I think there's one backstage.
Get a pistol, pop a dog, carry on. And it's gone.
Hello and welcome back to That Morning. Now,
up next
in the studio, we've got identical twins John and Andrew McNeil. Welcome to the show.
Nice to see you.
In shining armour.
As I understand it, John, you can only say the start of popular sayings, and Andrew, you can only say the end of them. How has this affected you emotionally?
'Tis better to have loved and lost than
a free lunch.
And why do you think that you in particular were born with this ability?
Good things come to those who
air your dirty linen in public.
Has this affected your family in any way?
Children should be seen, not
far from the tree.
Don't throw the baby out
and eat it.
People who live in glass houses should
suck eggs.
And is there any solution to this affliction?
To kill two birds
is the best medicine.
Right, well, that is certainly unorthodox. What would be the biggest piece of advice you'd give to someone else who's suffering from this problem?
Give a man a fish
to spite your face.
Patience is a
molehill.
Don't cut off your nose.
Catchy monkey.
Okay. What would you say the biggest things you've learned from the whole experience has been?
You can't make an omelette.
any final comments?
Life is like a box of chocolates.
You never know which one you're gonna get.
What? That one was right. Oh, that must happen
once in a blue.
Silver lining.
What you say?
Sorry, can I just get a dozen bread rolls, please?
Oh, right you are. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12,
cheers.
13.
No, sorry, I only needed a dozen.
Right, and I just gave you a dozen.
That's not a dozen.
Oh, sorry, it's a baker's dozen, sorry.
No, sorry, a dozen is 12.
And then one more.
Really?
No.
What do you mean no?
Oh, sorry, that's a baker's no? It means yes. Okay, I see you're a bit flustered. Calm down. Sit yourself in that chair over there, all right?
It's not a chair.
It's a baker's chair.
It's a table.
As I said, baker's chair.
Hello? Hi there, can you tell me the way to the vegan cafe?
Yeah, it's right, then left, then straight on. No worries.
That is not the way.
It's the baker's way.
It's the way to the abattoir. You're just wrong.
You lemon meringue. It's a baker's fuck off.
Oh,
hello there, Barry the Butcher. How's it going?
All right, Larry, I'll take a couple of bread rolls, thanks.
Right you are. One, two, three, and a sausage on
there. How's the wife?
Yeah, not too bad. It's just our triplets, actually.
Oh, two little nippers running around.
Yeah. How are your kids?
He's all right. About 27 now, he's just been arrested for underage drinking.
Oh, blimey.
And you and your wife Sheila, you're off on holiday soon.
In the desk drawer, mate, below the stapler.
They still selling them, are they?
About 12:30, I think, yeah.
They drove up and down my lawn, the baggers!
Saving Private Ryan.
How do you two understand each other?
Oh, well, you know, when you've been in a trade for a while, you learn to understand each other's lingo. What about you? What trade are you in?
I make candlesticks.
Ah, how appropriate. A butcher, a baker, and a pilot.
Can I just have a baker's dozen minus one bread roll, please?
Carry the seven. Oh, right. Why didn't you say so? Who's a gingerbread man?
Hi, Mr.
Shaggy. Shaggy Rogers.
Nice to meet you, Shaggy. I'll be your new vet. I'll be doing your dog's yearly checkup. So how old is this magnificent animal?
Oh, he's 48.
He must be 7 years old in human years.
No, he's 48.
Oh. Well, he's morbidly overweight. What have you been feeding him?
Hundreds of biscuits a day. More if he's good or particularly brave.
That's not enough to explain it. What else are you feeding him?
I occasionally give him impossibly tall and structurally implausible sandwiches.
It's orange.
He can talk?
Yeah, I mean, with a significant speech impediment.
Well, listening to his heartbeat, it's very irregular. Has he been exposed to anything that might cause him distress?
Yeah, oh yeah. The list goes on. He's been terrified by ghosts, mummies, vampires, and obviously there's fireworks on, which he hates.
Right, well, I'm afraid your dog has a heart condition.
No.
We're going to have to put him down.
Okay.
And then put him down.
What? No!
I don't trust him, Raggy.
Okay, Scoobs. What if he's not really a vet? I bet he's wearing a mask, and I bet he thought he could get away with it if it wasn't for us meddling kids. Come on, let's get that mask off. Where's the seam? There's no seam. You're a vet.
Shaggy, your dog has just died.
Scoobs! What if it's not really Scooby? Bet you thought you'd get away with it if it wasn't for us meddling kids. Let's get that mask off, you old lily-livered pooch. He's dead.
Right.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight.
Well, I'm not fucking sleeping anymore, am I? Get on me of your pair of guns! Get on this fucking of it!
Right, Andrew, let's see your work from last night.
I think you're going to be happy. I've finalised the layout of the keyboard.
Great.
Now, as we discussed, it would make most sense if the first letter was Q.
A. A.
Q.
Okay, that it would make sense if you followed that with U.
W, twice as good.
Why?
Well, it just felt right. And it spells, as you can see.
Q-W-E-R-T-Y.
Yes, or QWERTY, as I like to say it. Go on, it's catchy and fun. Say it yourself.
QWERTY.
Yes. Yeah, see, you're not enthralled by that one. Well, you like the letter F, so I've included that. And 12 variations on that theme, so we've got F1, F2, F3.
QWERTY-Fs.
Well, it's the prettiest letter, isn't it?
No, it's not.
Okay, well, let's not panic. We've got the numbers as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Zero.
Why is zero at the end?
Ace is high! Ha! let's not worry. La pièce de résistance. Check this out.
Well, that's just the numbers again.
Correct. But this time in a 3x3 matrix. Ooh!
Why?
Well, user ability. I'll give you an example. If you want to type 11, for example, if that's your child's age, you can go 1-1 or 1-1, or for the agnostic, 1-1.
That's not impressive.
Well, if you don't like them, you can lock them with this butter, numlock. Located next to the equally useful scroll lock for those who hate papyrus.
Why do we have a numlock and a scroll lock button when we're already pressed for space?
Oh, did somebody say press space? Boom! Ha!
No! Then why is it so big? Wait, what?
Hang on.
There's no menu button.
Yes. Vis-a-vis the old menu button, we couldn't fit one in, so we, fear not, we went for the intuitive combination, Control, Alt, and Delete. And on the topic of keyboard shortcuts, you'll love this one, press space 5 times and you get sticky keys!
What's that?
Yeah, we don't know about that.
This is not what I was expecting! This is not a keyboard!
It's a baker's keyboard.
So this is the climactic scene where Harold is showing the audience how to make the perfect fajita. So what we want, lots of intensity, lots of emotion. Great. Are you ready, Clive?
Yeah, sure.
And action.
So we're going to get our ingredients out, our lamb and our onions. And the first thing we're going to do is take a nice juicy onion and just cut.
Yeah, okay, got that.
Why have you stopped?
It's a cut.
The word cut is in the scene.
Right.
Okay. Right, take 5.
Yeah, we all need a break. I'll see you in a minute.
We're doing the 5th take, Clive. Come back.
Right, okay.
And action.
So the next thing we need to do is take our fajita dough and just roll it into a perfect circle, and once you've stopped that, you can just stop rolling.
Yeah, good. That was a really good bit as well.
Why did you stop now?
He said stop rolling.
The fajita, Clive. The fajita.
Gosh, this is a tricky scene.
Right, let's just go for putting the mix in the dough.
Great. And now what we're going to do, we put our fajita mix into the dough, add some chili to taste, some guacamole or sour cream, and that's a wrap.
Okay, good. We're done filming. Hey.
The fajita again, Clive. The fajita.
Oh, that's a wrap.
Now a bit of a pro tip. I like to grate a bit of cucumber gently into my sour cream, and then you have that as a lovely garnish. Agus, add a sprig of mint, and you've got yourself a perfect fajita.
Great, that was wonderful, guys.
Woo! Well, hey!
Guys.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Fuck. I've left the lens cap on.
How far to the next village?
20 miles as the crow flies.
What?
It's 20 miles as the crow flies.
How's that relevant? Do I look like a crow?
That's not what I'm saying, Mel. It's 20 miles as a crow would fly it.
Right, and how would a crow fly it?
Perfectly straight line.
Right. You've never seen a crow fly, have you?
No.
You've never seen a crow, have you?
I've seen a dead crow.
Okay, great. Hold that thought. Get rid of it. Now imagine you're a crow flying along.
Perfectly straight.
No, that's where you're going wrong. At some point, it would turn.
No.
Yeah. Observe. On my way to the next town as a crow. Oh, look, a worm.
You turn!
I know, that's what crows do. They turn.
No, that's how buzzards fly. You're thinking of a buzzard.
When have you seen a buzzard?
I've seen a dead buzzard.
Okay, great. I've seen a crow double back on itself.
Fuck off.
I've seen a crow zigzag.
Now you're eating my dick.
No, I'm not, and that's not a saying. I've seen a crow. I've seen a crow.
I've seen a dead crow.
We've all seen a dead crow, Kevin. I've seen a crow make more U-turns than Nick Clegg on tuition fees.
That's an oddly shoehorned, tired political reference from you, Mel.
All I'm saying is crows do not fly in a straight line.
Fine.
You know what does fly in a straight line?
What?
Nothing! Nothing flies in a straight line! We've got to stop using birds to measure distance! Now, where are we in relation to the next town?
Well, if you look at it from a bird's eye view...
Today is a day for heroes! Today is a chance to write our names in the history books alongside the greats! Achilles! Hercules! The other greats! Today we fight! Today we die! Oh!
Where are they?
I don't know.
We did say 12:30, right?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Where did we say we'd meet them again?
Large green field.
Large green field. Ah, right. So normally you just expect to bump into the invading army, but I guess realistically they could be in any one of the many thousands of fields that live on the South Devon coast.
Messenger from the other side!
Enemy!
I'm sorry about the old field mix-up.
Yeah, where are we actually meant to be, sorry?
About 1 mile as the crow flies.
Right.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. You're not going to be wearing that for the real thing, are you?
We always wear metallic grey.
No, we always wear metallic grey. You're going to have to change.
Change our armour. We're the home team. You invaded us. You change.
No, we will not change.
Okay, all right, let's find a diplomatic solution to all this. The clothes thing, not the battle, still very much up for the battle. Let's just wear metallic grey, both of us. It'll have to be confusing, okay?
As it always is. Now, I'll ref the first half, and then your messenger boy does the second.
Wait a second. That hill over there, very steep. Who gets the high ground?
Mm. Well, obviously, at half time, we switch ends.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now, on that point, I'd like to chat through a few rules with you. First of all, nothing above the knee, yeah? Yeah, I don't want any injuries out there, okay? I say this every year and someone always comes back with no head, okay? In addition to that, what formation are you guys doing?
Yeah, so we're thinking of archers at the back, then in front of them some pikemen, then one lone standard bearer at the front for sort of cannon fodder slash human shield. That's Bruce.
And, right, well, the most important thing I wanted to talk to you about, really, is celebrations.
Oh, yeah.
Woo! Chainmail does not go above the head, yet it's grotesque and it's barbaric.
So how long will each half be?
45 minutes each way, followed by the standard 2 days or so of injury time.
I'm ready if you're ready, let's go.
Off to war, sharpening our swords, getting all the girls, but maybe doing what?
Hello, Sonic, just got you a drink.
Thanks, girl. Are you just talking to the toy soldiers? Yeah, just giving them a pre-match team talk, you know how it is.
Right, you know they're not real, don't you?
But if they're not real, then why am I holding a lance?
Because you're a son of mine! Give me that mead, we're going to the jousting tourney!